Welcome to Majesty's House of Music. Like I said last week, we did a section on how to sound better in F sharp. Now that was part one, so today I'm going to be doing part two. Simple, like I said, first rule is you need to know your major scale, yeah? Okay, both hands. At least know the major scale. So that you don't miss out on certain notes. Then know your triads. Remember, this is what we said. After you know your triads, begin combining the triads. So I said combine the 1 and the 3, the 2 and the 4, the 3 and the 5, then the 4 and the 6. I even gave you a song example, your alpha. So that's a 4. Anyway, so I said today I'm going to start on the 5. So, here is your 5. Normal circumstance. Or this one. Then you have your 7 on your right hand. So, now, this is what you would have played. F, A flat, B. But then you have this. B, F, A flat, yeah. That C sharp F and A flat on your left hand, then you have B, F and A flat. Now if you repeat these two notes, no problem, it doesn't really get muddy. This is not low, okay? So that's not really a problem, yeah, something of the sort. So that's your 5, okay? But then I have to teach you other 5s that we use. Normally, what we like to do is, before we go to this 5, we like to come from another kind of 5 chord. Now, this is what I called resolving, but we'll do a whole topic on resolving. Anyway, this is what we like to do. So that now you have C sharp, F sharp and A flat on your left hand. Then you have B, E flat and A flat. That's a 2 chord on your right hand, okay? Okay? So you have that. Then what you do, drop the E flat to the C sharp and then drop the F sharp to the F. So you have remember. So you have C sharp, F, A flat, then you have B, C sharp, and A flat. So that's what normally most musicians will do. It's resolving, yeah? And that normally leads you to the 1. Obviously, you know there are other kinds of 5. Like now, if we were playing your alpha, we wouldn't play this. We would only play that at the end. What we would play at is the 1 over the 5. You know there is something like a 1 over 5, right? So that's a C sharp, F sharp, A flat, B flat. I'm just adding notes so that it sounds a bit more complete, yeah? C sharp, F sharp, A flat, B flat. Then you have C sharp, F sharp, and B flat, yeah? So that's simple. That's like adding notes to my chord so that it sounds better. So how many 5 chords do we have? So we have chords for the 5. We have these, we have these two that one resolves to the other, so, and then we have now the 1 over 5, which is, so now if you are playing a song like your alpha, so this is your 1. have to play the 1 over 5 first. Then you resolve to this now, you see? The 7 over the 5. Okay? So I want you to take note of those 5 chords. So you have this, resolving to this, you have this straight and forward, and then you have the 1 over the 5. You can always play this as much as you want, from whichever kind of inversion you want to play it. Anyway, that's about the 5 chord. I think that should help you sound a little bit better. Now let's go to the 6 chord. The 6 chord, you play over the 1, so you have your 6, then you have your 1. So you have E flat, F sharp, B flat, then you have this chord. But like I said, I like to bring my chords closer, so I'll bring this C sharp here. So I have E flat, F sharp, and B flat, then I have C sharp, F sharp, and B flat here. Now, sometimes maybe I want to sound a little bit more compact. Maybe I want to make my chord a bit heavier, so I just add this note, A flat. So, see that? Something of the sort. So you have E flat, F sharp, A flat, and B flat. And then you have this, C sharp, F sharp, and B flat. Okay? So you can have that. You can have the normal one. You can have that. Or you can also decide to drop the 1 to the 7 on your right hand. So that now it becomes something like this. Okay. So E flat, F sharp, A flat, and C sharp. And B flat, I mean, on your left hand. Then you have C sharp, F, and B flat. That's a 3 chord, okay? So something of the sort. So you have choices. You can choose whichever chord you want. So you can play this. That was the first chord. The second chord, you add this note. And the third chord is you drop this here. So you have this. Okay? So you can have any of those. Any of those will work. I mean, any of those sounds good, right? Yeah, so. Or. Instead of. So, yeah, any of those will sound good. Yeah, so that's your 6. Six, yeah? Now, you have your 7. Your 7 is mostly this. It's a diminished chord. F, A flat, and B. But, like I said in the beginning, sometimes we like to make it like look like a 5 chord. So, it would be something like this, yeah? So you play the same thing on both hands. That's F sharp. That's F, I mean, F, A flat, and C sharp on both hands, yeah? Something of the sort. Now, I said you could play the seven over the 2. Like, in my theory, if you look at what we are doing, you could play the 2 over the 7. Like, you could have the 7, and then you could have the 2. So, and then bringing this down here, you have something like, see that? E flat, A flat, and B. So you have something of the sort. Then you have F, A flat, and B. Yeah? Now, normally for that chord, you don't just use it conventionally as a 7. You use it, how do you use it? You use it to go to, it takes you to the 3 chord. Normally, mostly that chord, yeah? Yeah? Yeah, the 2 over the 7. Let me give you that chord. It's a chord that most people normally use. You will find most people using this chord, yeah? So you have D, F sharp, A flat, and C sharp. Okay. Yeah, then you have B, F sharp and A flat. These two notes are repetitive on both hands, yeah? Then you can go to the six. Or, you see? So you can do the seven, to the three, to the six. Okay? So, something like that will make you look good. If you want it to keep straight seven, just play it as if it's a five. It's as if it's an inversion of the five. So that one, F, A flat, and C sharp on both hands. Yeah. So that makes it look like it's an inversion of the five. Yeah. So now you have your one to the seven. So you have your one. You have your two. You have your three. Now for the three, let me give you another tip. For the three, you don't always have to play it with the Fs. See these Fs? You don't have to play it with the F. You can always sharpen the Fs to the F sharp. Okay, so you can have this or this. See that chord? So you can have this or this. And I normally like to use this chord a lot when I'm playing, yeah? So you can have this, or you can have this. You can have B flat, F sharp, A flat, C sharp, F sharp. That's just an extra tip for the three. So yeah, if you made it to this part of the video, lucky you. Anyway, so that's three. Then you have your four, like I said, with the six. Then you have your five, different forms of five. So you have this one. This one, or you have the 1 over 5, which normally now leads to the 5. Okay, then you have your 6, or this, or just this, remember? Then you have your 7, that's a straight 7, if you wanted to look like a straight 7. But if you wanted to play like a 7-3-6, like I said, you can now play the 2. Then I gave you this chord, then to the six. Okay, yeah. So now you are all wound up. Let's say you play your alpha. We play the first part. Da 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 da. You see that? Now instead of this, I actually played this. Yeah, you see that? Da 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 da. Going to the chorus, you can use the 7-3-6 as a passing chord. So see that? Two, four, one over five, seven. That's a five. I mean the 7/5. So you see, you can use those new chords to sound better instead of da-da-da-da. You see, so you can definitely use such sounds. And I layered piano with some MKS. For most keyboards, Yamaha, PSR, it's a DX Modern thing. You don't have to make the DX Modern sound so bad, okay? Yeah, just sound a little bit better. Yeah, but that's it. So try to practice those chords. I'll be putting a series of videos so that you see this in application in a real setting. But for now, these videos are. For now, just go learn those chords. As we go on, I'll show you where to use them. Anyway, this is a series, okay? This is just part two. You have so many lessons to go. Yeah. So that's it for the lesson. I'll see you in the next one.
So I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Now, there are just a few things I'd like you to do to help us spread this word and support us. The first thing is to go ahead and hit the like button below this video. Just go ahead and hit the like button. And the second thing you can do is to share this video on our social media platforms, on Facebook, on Twitter. Just go ahead and hit the share button so that will help us to spread this message so that more people can get access to these lessons. And the third thing is that if you have been watching my lessons and you're not subscribed to my channel, please just go right ahead right now. Now, log into Google with your Gmail, okay? With your Gmail, your email address, log into YouTube, and then hit the subscribe button so that you'll always be notified when I release new classes. And then the last thing you can do is to visit our website, majestieshouseofmusic.com. Then click on the piano video courses, and you'll see a list of several longer, detailed courses where I go much deeper into these concepts. Okay, so if you visit our website, you can order those courses there online if you have a PayPal account. If you don't have a PayPal account, you can just send me an email or a WhatsApp message, and then we can communicate on how you can order the courses and how I'll deliver them to you as downloadable files. I'll simply send to you a link and you can download the course that you are interested in. So thank you for following this channel, and God bless you. See you in the next class.